Hello, everybody. My name is Mitch, and we're here with the Voidbound crew doing all kinds of agrarian sky things. And today's goal is going to be...
Flint's death. Oh.
Wow.
Yeah. Flint has decided, for reasons we're still fathoming, or I'm still fathoming, that he's going to go building down... we need a basement.
We need a basement for power and extra stuff.
So he's apparently manning up. And
by manning up, we mean, okay, everybody hit the T key on your keyboards and read the last message. Flint and Steel fell out of the world. That's what we mean by manning up, Flint. Good job.
But fortunately, DNH, like, laid down the law, and he's like, you will have nothing on you. You will have nothing. Like, it was kind of hardcore to listen to, like, damn.
He's mean, but he's right.
So actually, and Flint made the very reasonable argument, like, power generation takes ridiculous amounts of space, so having it in the basement and being able to run power pipes wherever we want without it, like, without Flint and I having emotional breakdowns from the power lines being everywhere would probably be a good idea. So I think I'm gonna work on getting one of those really fancy crops going. Like, so the crossbreeding I understand reasonably well now. Like I get it for the most part. So now I'm gonna try that new, like, the redstone. That specific ore. What was it called again?
Redstoneium. No, I don't know. The redstone ore.
The plant.
Oh, yeah, redstone dorindon. Redstone dorindon.
Wow.
Say that 10 times fast.
Is it?
Yeah, I can't say it one time fast.
Okay, so red tulip seeds. They take poppy seeds, which take sugar cane and pumpkin. I don't think we have pumpkin, do we? Or we did at one point.
We have pumpkin seeds, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, okay, so, oh crap.
They're in this center chest. We have pumpkin and melon seeds, so.
All right,
You insisted that your platforms were not appropriately laid out for the pumpkin seeds at this point.
Well, they're not really, but.
And the D and H solution of just slap down some blocks was not adhered to.
I can't imagine why. It baffles me why that would. All right, let's be honest. Did you really think anybody was going to go for that except for you? Like I'm curious.
Honestly, no. I really didn't. You're right. My bad. Okay, we can move on. That's fine.
I'm a trash bin.
What you did, Flint? You did move the gear cast. Where did you put that?
It's right here.
Is it back over there? Okay.
Yeah, it's right in here. I'll put it right back in the chest. For...
Well, I was gonna make one more. I'll grab
sorry.
It. We probably should have a chest over there, I guess.
Make
one of those. I was gonna do another Electrum gear real quick.
Alrighty, so we have a small platform down there, and so I'm gonna go down and light it up.
He enjoys singing that too much.
Okay, you know it's dark right now.
Uh-huh.
So, are there mobs?
No.
Down there, since you left it unlit?
No, we're good. All's well.
Okay, sure, you know, okay.
Why is there a trash can for energy? Like, there's one for fluids, which I kind of get, but why is there one for energy?
You're producing too much? I don't know.
Yeah, that's just...
Only sound like a Flint and Steel problem because I've never produced too much energy.
I say you can never produce too much energy.
Yeah, that's why I was going blinky. I need a place to put this. I guess over here. Yeah, over there will kind of work. Builder problems are real, people. I could hear the eye roll, DNH. Like, you might have detached the retina.
No, I was not. That was not what happened there.
Uh-huh.
I was in my own world there. I wasn't paying attention to it.
All right, so actually, I have a conversation topic, since you guys are terrible about starting a conversation. And yes, I'm totally calling you out. So I keep trying this with Flint. Over in our 7 Days to Die world, I'm trying to find a cultural common ground with him. I'm failing utterly. Like it's bad. So name some things like cultural things that you guys like grew up with, for example, like cartoons or whatever. Like,
hear the crickets? Oh, okay. I don't know. Cartoons that I grew up with, or things that I grew up with. I don't know.
Like what cartoons did you watch growing up?
I watch Saturday morning cartoons some. I mean, I love any of the Looney Tunes or Merry Melody stuff, Bugs Bunny, Daffy Duck.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah.
Mickey Mouse, Flintstones was a big one for me. Somewhat to Jetsons.
Oh, and you know what? I kind of skipped those stages. Like, I do you know the cartoons in the 90s?
No, because I'm crazy older than you. So, you know.
Okay, then.
What happened in the 90s? Power Rangers or something? I don't know.
Well, I had friends into that. I was never big into that, but
I was totally into that. Me and a neighbor, we were totally Power Rangers all day. Is it possible to have someone drop me down a stack of cobble?
Yeah, that's fine. I got it.
Sticks for a ladder.
I'm not as into that one. I don't know. I think we should keep him down there forever.
Is there any? Okay, I guess.
I can get sticks. Do you need sticks?
I have wood. I can make sticks. It's fine. Or you? Oh well, it's just right here. What do you drop in there, Mitch?
19 sticks.
Thank you, sir. So,
at least Mitch still likes.
There's a little bit more wood too there, in case you need it.
I might need a crafting table. It's actually a smart idea.
And here's some rotten flesh.
Because you were gonna just rub sticks together to make a ladder.
Exactly. Mitch drops down 7 rotten flesh for me. Gee, thanks, dude.
Hey, Mitch still likes you.
That is like feeding the hamster, is that what it is?
Yeah, yeah, and you're the brain.
Look at the guy building that ridiculous platform. Let's start chucking stuff at him and see if he,
see if he can use it. It's like Survivor. Let's see what resources we can give him and what he'll do with them.
Now, yeah, we check back in 15 minutes. It's going to be something really amazing down there, I'm sure.
You know, occasionally you guys make me feel like less of a terrible person. It's great.
Just because we're also willing to experiment on our fellow man? Is that
correct? Well, you know.
Which is wearing a nice helmet.
We're getting dangerously close to making the Nazi jokes. I'm not sure this is going to a good place, guys.
What?
Wait, what?
That turned really quickly, so okay. So cartoons again. I don't remember the Nazi branded cartoons. So.
I don't know, dude. Have you ever watched some of the really old Disney stuff?
Yeah, I was gonna say there. I think there's a Donald Duck one where he's like working in some kind of Nazi factory.
Yeah, and then there's like the Private Snuffy ones.
Uh huh.
So some fun facts here. They used to show because back in the World Wars. The common denominator for soldier IQ was occasionally a little bit lower than usual. Let's put this politely. Most of them were fine, but you had to go for the lowest common denominator, right? So they put together these cartoons, and some of these are like whoa. But yeah, there's was it Private Snuffy or something like that? If you ever go looking for that sort of stuff on the YouTubes, you can find it. It's kind of interesting.
Okay, so kids out there who are watching our videos, Griffin is apparently giving you homework that is going to get you in major trouble with your parents. It so why is there a zombie here?
Cultural literacy.
Why was there a zombie walking around?
That's not my fault.
He wanted exercise?
It's not your fault? Is that what you're saying, Flint?
Exactly.
Or do we believe him? I'm not sure I believe him.
How is he? They can't climb ladders.
I don't know. It was walking around. I'm not sure how that happened.
Pretty sure we still blame you, Flint. I'm just saying. Alright, let's see.
Wait, what? Doo-doo-doo.
Oh, soon, Rhubarb. Soon you will be 10-10-10 and I can move on with my life.
Okay, that was weird. What? I just saw DNH like walk across the void, like nothing was there.
Oh, well,
woohoo!
He's moonwalking. I mean, wait. One of these days, we actually need to get to flying. That would be great.
Yeah. Eventually.
But I mean, I think power generation is a thing before that, isn't it? Because, I mean, I'm assuming jetpacks are the way to go there.
And or angel wings.
Wait, are there angel wings are pretty far down the... They're Draconic. I speak the English.
Whoa, what?
If you say so.
Shut up, Mitch. No, I asked you.
So any of the 90s sitcoms you're fancy, like Seinfeld or Friends or...
You know, for whatever reason, to this day, I still don't do sitcoms.
I love sitcoms, but I never did Seinfeld or Friends.
Well, what's your favorite sitcom?
My favorite? King of Queens.
Okay.
I heard the joke.
Zero episodes of that, so let's see. Oh. Again, sticking with the theme that I'm older than you all, mine was more like Married with Children.
Yeah, that was
good. They played reruns of that, and every once in a while I would watch that, yeah.
It's weird now to see, like, Ed O'Neill on Modern Family and stuff, so.
I saw on the internet they made this gag. He's still reading the same newspaper. Did you ever see that?
No.
Yeah, it's a cute little thing they did. He's still that newspaper that he was always reading and Married with Children. It never uh-huh. changed, and he's reading the same one in that one apparently.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah. So see, I'm helpful. Now you can look
exactly.
For that.
Exactly.
Okay, platform has been started.
Yay!
Now we just need to sieve all the things.
I was looking at my YouTube analytics the other day, actually. This was another interesting thing. And almost entirely Minecraft content. So you kind of get the feeling that they're all like, okay, you know, US is probably number one and London and whatever, you know, or England as far as countries that are watching you. So the United States is number one in my analytics, but the number two country that watches me is Vietnam.
Really?
For some reason. I have absolutely no idea. So hello out there to everybody in Vietnam who's watching this these videos. I think they're probably focused on my time lapse or something. Like maybe it's more of a technical thing, but
maybe.
But yeah, I don't know why Vietnam is popular with with Minecraft. Not that they can't be. It's just
it wasn't the one you're thinking of.
Yeah, I mean, like people who make Minecraft content on YouTube, I just don't see that many from Vietnam or whatever. So I thought that was kind of interesting. Poking around in your analytics stuff is always kind of like, wow, that's an interesting trip.
I am, you know what, the sad part is, I am nowhere near the kind of YouTuber, like, my levels don't justify looking at my analytics, I just do this for fun as a hobby.
Well, and I'm not saying mine justify, I mean, I'm not making, you know, paying bills or whatever, I'm just saying, you know, even if you have a few hundred people, they all come from somewhere.
True enough.
It's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Griffin doesn't have a few hundred people.
You have a few hundred views. I don't know, Griffin. No. You have 100 and something.
Man is making it up as he goes. Give him credits.
I mean, my average video doesn't get that many views either, so. Nah. We're all in the boat. We're all in the boat where we're just hanging out together. Hey, how's it going, Mitch?
Hi. Oh, I see you put gear on, too.
Yeah, exactly. I had to look all fancy and stuff.
And we also have this convenient armor stand here now, too.
Ooh, fancy.
That has tons of little slots on it that I have no clue what they're for.
I think Mitch is just taken to, okay, I'm just going to do all the quests. These guys go faffing off and doing whatever. I'm going to actually try and make progress.
Yep, Mitch is actually accomplishing the goals of Agrarian Skies, too.
I am working towards one of the big goals. Well, not immediately at the moment. I need to get these rhubarbs 10-10-10 and off into the farm. That's just... Takes some time.
Yeah, exactly. We've got the rhubarb goal, Griffin. No.
it needs to be perfect. But it must be perfect. I mean, I've got a few of them on the tens, so I just need to finish the rhubarb up. And then we can go into the more exotic crops, trying to get the flowers and such. Which actually serves another goal of irritating DNH, because then I can hand Mitch flowers and he can go around prettying up the place.
Ooh, I want flowers.
I will make that happen for you. I promise.
Okay. I'm scared.
Okay. Well, make sure it's at about 28 minutes into the recording. So
I will try to hit that goal.
We can end on a high note.
Yeah.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, We have obsidian.
Nice. Good job. Awesome.
Wait, right? Yes, we do.
And that's we're looking at that for the builder's wand for Mitch?
Yeah. And for anybody who wants it once we get enough diamonds.
Oh, yeah, true. But, you know, Mitch is actually good at it, so probably should focus on him first.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I have zero need for a builder's wand at this point, you know. Just a couple blocks of cobblestone, and I'm good. Oh.
You have... Don't you want things to look nice, DNH? I mean, really, come on.
Want versus, you know... Yeah, no, I don't really want that. It's just...
Wow. Wow.
Gauntlet I was going to say down. Want versus need, but, you know, all even right, want is a strong word. Enjoyable, I like it. It's kind of cool, you know? I mean, but want awesome. Is, you know... Want is a strong word. But,
I don't know. I've watched some of your time lapses. Your stuff looks nice.
Thank you. Thank you.
So I think he's punking us.
Well, in my time lapses are also me build random cobblestone platform and then eventually get around to tearing that down and making it look nice. But you know.
Well, I mean, but you do that second part. You get around to it.
There you go.
We're just kind of front loading.
Yeah, you're front loading.
So I think I'm managing. Effing crop, or effing weeds. Ah, maybe we waste sticks. Frustrating. Wow, I complained about them, now they're really going to town. I am glad we have this watering can. This would be super frustrating without the watering can.
Definitely true. So you and Flynn didn't find any common ground in cartoons. So what about video games? I mean, we all play video games. So what?
Except he started like video games in more recent years. So if I try to talk about any of
started,
like
2 years ago.
Yeah. So I talk about like the Sierra games or anything like that, and he's like,
What are you 12? How did you only start playing video games?
So when I was a kid, I had an NES, and then it just cut for about 10 years.
And he didn't do computer games.
And so. Then I had a PS1 when the PS1 came out. I had a PS1 for about a year or so. Cut there. And about 2 years ago, I got a gaming PC. 2 or 3 years ago. Like that.
Wow.
Yeah, this is what I have to deal with. Like, how do you...
yeah. Okay.
Like, okay.
I don't know that I can talk to you anymore, Flynn. give me a minute to process.
Are you disowning me?
And we'll come back to you later. So yeah, Griffin, Sierra Games, and you're right now on your channel, which you apparently need more viewers for. You're doing Monkey Island 2, which is LucasArts, you know, but adventure game. I'm loving that. I'm watching that series.
Aww, thank you. And I was not fishing for more views. I was mostly just giving you shit. I'm sorry.
I know. I'm just giving you help. But I grew up playing all the like Space Quest, King's Quest.
Oh God, I love those games. Did you ever play Dr. Brain?
I did. And
I love Dr. Brain.
Yeah. I was watching you were doing one of those too. But I played the first like island, and I played Castle. I don't know that. I think there's like a couple others like Time.
Yeah, I forget if there's a Time Machine, but there was like the Lost Mind of Dr. Brain too. That was like one of the last ones they produced, and it was solid.
Yeah.
Although I found out during that one as a child that I am. Musically inept does not begin to describe what I am. So I had to pay one of my bribe one of my friends down the street who could play an instrument to come do the music part of that for me. It was bad.
That's good.
Yeah. But so, yeah. No, love those games. Absolutely love them.
So, what about you, Mitch?
Well, let's see. I started out mainly playing on Super Nintendo. Because I kind of like skipped the whole Nintendo first generation because we had like an old Atari 2600.
Mm.
I had from like some old garage sale, I think. And past that, I don't know, like the Mario, Castlevania. I was always a big fan of the Final Fantasy series too before it got like, well, like
bad. Like just say it like it is, man. Just it got bad.
Yeah, I mean Mario, Zelda, all those for me are definitely. I played Mario's every Mario up until fairly recently.
Oh, and I'm terrible at platformers, so, you know.
Okay, describe to me that what's a platformer?
Okay, so who's going down there to kill him? I think we might have to argue over the privilege.
Yeah, I'm not talking to him right now, so it's just it's literally like I still haven't processed the fact that he didn't play video games for the vast majority of his life, so, you know.
Okay, all right, so Shun, yes.
Is that why you guys sent me to the lower platform?
You sent yourself, we're just keeping you down there now. You can't come back.
I mean, at this point, you're lucky I'm not breaking the stuff so, to keep you down there.
I'm saying, did you break the ladder already?
No, it's fine. Don't be concerned.
Platformers, boy, it's so like I don't even know how to explain it, but yeah, like Mario Brothers, where you have really, I think it was based on that, where you have platforms that you're just kind of running across and jumping. Although side scroller, I guess, would technically platformer. It's... like, what would platformer even the definition be? Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of because there's games. Most games mix platformer with something else, so it's kind of. It can be tricky sometimes to exactly describe it.
Okay.
Well, like what's a classic platformer? I mean, I always think of, Mario usually.
Right.
It's the one I always go to.
Yeah, Mario Brothers, Mega Man, Metroid.
Yeah, Metroid really is probably the best.
I mean, really sort of side scroll, I guess. Probably not a lot different from. You know, Contra. I mean, those kind of things.
Okay, Contra's getting old even for me. I would forgive him not knowing that one.
No, Contra is still a good game series.
Okay, we have
one I've played a whole bunch.
Large-ish platform. I think it would make it larger. And it does have safety chains. That's good.
I still don't think we're allowing you to rejoin the tribe.
Too late, I'm already up the ladder.
I'm gonna kill him. Let's see.
And I'm down the ladder.
He's trying to make a break for it. Alright, so
okay. Hi Mitch.
So here's one within video games. That's actually a question for me. So I'm assuming here that Griffin, you're the only one that plays WoW.
Might be. Might could be.
You so, are. Mitch. Yeah. Okay. So, and I've never played it, and I've never like RPGs as a genre. You know, I mean, just never like some of the stuff for me just kind of sits badly. Like creating a character in the beginning and not really then being able to change that much, or you know, assigning points to things early on, or just like some of the fighting dynamic. And I don't think World of Warcraft is necessarily like just. Points-based fighting. I mean, there are decisions you make and orders and progressions and stuff. Yeah. But so what gets you? What do you like about World of Warcraft?
It's my back in the day. I started in vanilla and then I took a really long break during one of the expansions. I could speak WoW to you, but it would just not make sense, so I won't. It's my socialization. Like I have some friends I have in real life. Like. I see them in real life that we play. So I only usually play for raid, honestly. So it's socialization for me.
Okay. But you have like a level 100 war elf marine.
I have a warlock. Don't judge me. Cyber-Coptic. I summon demons and steal souls.
Okay. So, you know, basically appropriate for Griffin.
Man, that's harsh. I'm not saying it's not true, but that's harsh.
Okay, I'm gonna go make some more charcoal. Because I'm getting low in the torches.
Not a bad idea.
I always liked board games, but never really got into like the D&D stuff.
Oh, and I love D&D and Dresden Files and all of the things. That's yeah, I spend a disproportionate amount of my time doing that too.
Sorry, I said wait for a second. You know there's charcoal in one of those chests, Flint?
Wait, what?
One of the chests along by the furnaces had charcoal, plus there's some coal, actual coal in that's getting sifted out of the gravel.
Okay. I don't want to use the coal completely, because we may actually need it for such stuff and things, but...
Okay, you said we had pumpkin seeds. Where are they? I'm trying to get them.
Center chest.
Yep,
center
by chest? The power area.
The very, very platform.
Oh, okay. They were a reward and got put in there. My bad.
Yep. Okay. Like a long time ago, yeah. So
I forgot about that. That's your ore chest. Oh my god. This is why I'm losing my mind at you people.
Why?
Yep.
Why?
Because.
Why?
What did we do now, Griffin?
Well, okay, each of the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 chests.
Uh-huh.
Hate you all.
And the pattern is I like the pattern because it's like boom, 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 boom. All the way
looks like
here.
A transformer.
Like,
taking the bone meal so it can go in the chest it's supposed to be in. I hate you all so much.
Well, you're missing with the bone meal. What? And there's two random string in here. This isn't the awesome chest.
This is the chest.
It's the end of
the
episode, and DNH has managed to trigger me. Damn it!
There's like a stack and a half of actual coal in here too, by the way.
Well, that we determined was useful, and therefore we switched over to charcoal, if I recall.
In emergencies, I've used coal a couple of times.
We will never forgive you. You're dead to us forever.
Wait, haven't I already been for a while?
Maybe by the next episode we'll be able to forgive his lack of video game playing.
You have luck. I'm still having issues.
Okay, so when I came back to PC gaming, the first game I ever played was Rust.
Yeah, you were telling me about that one.
And that's what I started my entire channel on was Rust. And a little
really?
Bit of Minecraft.
Yeah, never played Rust.
Yeah,
I've only played Minecraft for about a year and a couple months.
Okay. Yeah, crickets. I played Minecraft since 2011, so that's all right.
He's
only judging you.
That really just actually that one really just sort of looks worse on me, so I'm not totally faulting you for that. But,
I made this builder. What is it?
All right. So the builder. It makes chests, and do we have time to explain this real quick?
So
you'll see how it says 9 columns and 3 rows.
Yeah.
Like that's a normal chest, right? Is 9 columns and 3 rows. So, but you can change that. So if you want to make a huge chest that has like say 6 rows or 8 rows, you can do the pluses or whatever.
Oh.
And then you can also make them backpacks or chests. And then what happens is, like, if you hover over the required materials, so to make a 9-column, 9-row chest, you need 2 regular chests, 9 iron, 9 iron bars, and 2 clay. If you put all that in those blocks below those things and then hit build chest, it'll spit out basically a big chest.
So is it, like, on the screen, like, when you lay it down, is it larger than normal, or is it just a, like, extra?
Nope, it's a 1-by-1... One by one chest when you put it.
Oh, so it's like it just has more inventory slots. Is that what I gather?
Yeah.
So kind of like the upgraded chest.
Gotcha.
Right. Or less. I mean, you can make like a tiny chest too. I mean, it's just you can make a custom sized one, basically.
Okay.
So whatever. And you can pick the colors. That's what's in the upper right. Like you can change the color you want.
Well, that's interesting.
Yep. So it builds chests for you. You want a big chest? Boom.
Boom.
I mean, I guess it has the advantage of, for, like, barrels, over barrels. Barrels can only hold one thing, so I guess that would be advantageous in many a way.
Yep. Okay. You said we're at time?
Yeah, I would say we're at time. So, unfortunately, I think this round goes to DNH. He managed to get me worked up. Damn guy.
Yay!
Oh, hello, Enderman.
Although, I think, really, Flint is just the universal loser there. Like...
Aww.
Flint,
oh.
Yeah.
Down from there. Oh, where'd he go? Oh, there he is.
Enderman's still alive then?
Yeah.
I'm glad we're doing a great job of lighting that platform up.
Hey, he can't climb the ladder, yo.
You knew going in when he started his task that was what was going to happen.
Hey, Mitch, when you went downstairs, was it lit up very, very nicely?
It was very lit. I saw
a
chandelier and everything.
A chandelier?
Oh, yeah, there's a chandelier down there somewhere.
Yeah, on top that of the... wasn't even Flint.
That wasn't even me. See?
I was just saying, that was that does not sound like
thing you focused on had nothing to do with Flint.
But I put torches down there. It's beautiful. Beautificated.
All right.
Oh, well, so I guess we'll sign it off there. On the good news, we did manage to get a ding on DNH right at the end. So
and we have power gen. Episode's over. And we have a platform. Beautifulness.
So that sigh is the end of the episode, people. Have a good one.
Bye.